Can you stay up for the weekend and blame God for looking too old? Can you find all that you stand for has been replaced with mountains of gold? You can untrain yourself to notice, to feel pain and swallow fear.
Welcome to Coach's Corner's first Best 15. I'm joined today by the one and only Peter Canavan, a past manager of my own and one of the finest managers I've had. I'm not just saying it because he's here. Peter's going to pick his Best 15, excluding all Tyrone men. So he's getting the easy option out there. Is that right, Pete?
Yeah, I'm not a fan of any Tyrone men here. There's too many I would want to put in, you see, wouldn't be fair on the rest of them.
No doubt. So, the keeper?
Keeper, the first selection I have down is John O'Leary. We've played against him on numerous occasions and always found him a very difficult man to get past. But I suppose if you look at the goalkeepers now and the influence that they have in games, I'd say back in the era that I was playing, O'Leary would come closest because he was a great ball player. His kicking out was fantastic, and he was a great leader and organiser. Other men that might have come close there, Mickey McVeigh from Down was an absolutely game kicking out and shot stopping was brilliant. Benny Tierney, maybe it was an arm on, but he's too fat.
It's a bit harsh.
The only thing that ruled him out of coming there.
Yeah. No problem. We'll see what Benny says about that. Left cornerback?
We'll start right cornerback is Kieran McKeever.
Very good.
Why? Because I just hated marking this man.
Very good.
When I started playing for Tyrone, you know, come off the back of good on the minor and under 21 teams, and you're going to play senior football, and you think everyone's going to come natural, come easy to you. First two or three times we played there in the championship, I hardly kicked the ball.
Right.
And it was because of this man here. Tight marker, hard as nails, would go through you for a shortcut, but he could also play football, and his anticipation and reading of the game was exceptional. So, without doubt, one of the toughest players that I've ever played against, a brilliant cornerback.
Very good. Big fullback, I'd say many fullback have maybe had to come across and mark you.
I'm going to have to put this man in here now, and literally could have put him anywhere. Seamus Moynihan from Kerry. He's played centre-back for Kerry, he's played midfield, centre-forward, I think. You can play him anywhere. I also had the privilege of playing with him in the international rules when Ireland played Australia. He never had a poor match. A real leader with Kerry, fantastic hands, great engine in him. And if you ask any of the Kerry players who was one of the most important players for this past couple of decades in Kerry, they'll all say highly respected by his peers. And a fantastic fella as well off the pitch. So Seamus Moynihan,
very good. Unanimous. And to fulfil the full back line.
That's right. Another tight marker. And I've been very good to my neighbours here. And there, another man that I didn't like to play against was Sean Murray.
Yeah.
Again, very similar to Kieran McKeever. Obviously, I spoke to Kieran McKeever before he went out to mark me.
Yeah.
But also had the privilege of playing with him for Ireland as well. And a lot of these players have either played against or played with for Ulster,
yeah,
or played with for Ireland. And again, Sean Marty, I think when Ireland played Australia, he picked up a couple of players of the series. And this is against professionals.
Yeah.
And set himself very high standards. And very seldom did he disappoint. So, Sean Murray Lockhart.
That's two there already. All right. So, to the wing half backs.
Yeah, we're going back down the country to a very famous footballer named Tomás O'Shea.
Yeah.
Speaks for himself, Tomás. And again, very similar to Sean Murray in that he set very high standards for himself. And very seldom would you see him having a bad game. Bombing up this right wing, kicking points, scored a great goal against Tyrone in the All-Ireland final 2005 as well. And the other dimension that you'd expect with O'Shea is the more competitive the game got, the more competitive this boy got.
Yeah.
And he's the type of boy, when you go to battle with, you'd want him there.
Very good, very good. Number six, we're definitely getting phone calls on the way up the road here, but That's Mr. McCluskey.
Aye, now McCluskey would think that I'd be putting him in here, but and I've marked him as well when he was playing cornerback, Ryan McCluskey, and a very tight mark as well. Later years, he's a great reader of the game and played it. But I would put him there, only, you know, he's too hard to listen to, and there's not a chance I'm going to put him in here.
I wouldn't have him any other
I suppose I played, again, a lot of men in the early 90s who were exceptional in this position, and Henry Downey is one man that will definitely stand out. But the other one is Kieran McGeaney, because he dominated this position, and the whole centre of his defence when he was playing for Armagh. If he wasn't playing here for Armagh, I wouldn't have won that Ireland. So I think it's for me, and again, I played again at minor level. You know, they were marked me on Tyrone Players Armagh many years ago, and at senior level too. So ultra competitive.
Yeah.
You knew what you were going to get, and a fantastic leader.
He's in the deep end now with Armagh as well, so.
Yeah, and no better man. You know, it's no coincidence that when he went to assist with Armagh last year, that their fortunes rose. So, definitely one man you want to have in your team, anyway.
No problem. The last of the defence of six.
Again, I'm going to go down the country and pick a Dublin man. We played against Dublin. We lost an All-Ireland final back in '95, and that's one of the reasons why we did. He was a player, I suppose I was when he started playing, or played 3 or 4 years, and any time he played in Dublin, Paul Cornwell was exceptional. His fitness levels, I suppose at that time, seemed to be much superior to everyone else. And he could also play in the half forward line. Any time he went forward, he had great feet. So he's another man that I would have admired, and is very deserving of that position.
Very good, very good. On to the hub of the team, midfield. You've only got two options here,
yeah. Again, you know, you ask any county player from the past 10 or 15 years, and they can, you know, give you 10, 12 exceptional midfielders. The two that I'm going to select is a brother of Tomás, Dara O'Shea. I would say, you know, when it comes to the skills of the game, I'll use the example of the 2005 All-Ireland Final. When things weren't going that well for Kerry, when Throne weren't up, this was the man that stood up to the plate. He was able to come forward that day, kick scores off his right foot, kick scores off his left, and his fetching ability, he was just awesome in the air. And again, like the brother, when things started to get tough and you needed a man to stand up and put manners on a few men, there's nobody better than Dara.
Very good.
And he would tell you that too.
Right, it's not hard to back it up.
The other man would be considered maybe a more graceful midfielder.
Very good.
Would definitely be Anthony Tuchel. Again, played against him, Derry at Queen's. Himself and Paul Brewster, James McCartan, there were a host of county men back then, and Tuchel was their main man. Would Derry have won All Ireland if he hadn't been midfield? I know Brian McGilligan was brilliant alongside him, but Tuchel was a real driving force for Derry. And again, played with him at International Rouge level, and fantastic player on off the pitch. So again, without doubt, he would be one player that I would definitely have there.
So you have three Derry men in there?
Three Derry, that's where stopping that. Right.
Okay, so on to the attractive side of the game now, as you could say, the forwards.
Yeah.
Half forward line.
Right. And again, I mentioned Queens there. This is another man who caused a bit of bother when I was at Queens, when I was playing for St Mary's. James McCartan.
Very good.
From minor under 21, any time I played against him, he was something that's an explosive player. Bit similar in stature to yourself, only he could score. I suppose the traits of a lot of these men that I'm picking, McKeever, McKinney, O'Shea's, and James McCartan, was the willingness to work hard and to get stuck in and to battle. His performance in the 91 All-Ireland Final, was it, when Down defeated Meath, where he received the Man of the Match award, and the abuse that he took that day, but he didn't waver in what he was doing. And again, when he had the ball, you had to do something to try and get it off him. He was, for such a small man, physically very strong. And again, I played with him at Ulster level too. He's one man that you want to have on your side.
No problem. Number 11, will mean coveted spot of many players, myself included.
Yeah.
But who are you going for number 11?
Number 11 was very difficult because, as you say, you're some of the greats of Ulster football. I played number 11, Greg Planey, Martin McHugh, Shane McKay. I stayed clear of Ulster and I went further down south, again to a man that I witnessed playing at close hand with the international rules, and that was Ja Fallon.
Very good.
From Galway. And what he brought to the game, you know, apart from his industry and working hard, he was so strong in the air. Mm-hmm. And the 98 All-Ireland final against Kildare, Galway were struggling in the first half. Fallon came out, caught a couple of great balls. He kicked a couple from the sideline. He went through and played Galway in an All-Ireland Under 21 final that he was playing. Fallon was actually full forward and they kicked it into him and he was able to do the business. So he could have played anywhere for them, but a real graceful player, brilliant jink and sidestep to get past players. So again, Ja Fallon, I think, is very merited for that position.
Very good, very good. Wing half, the last wing.
You play this man anywhere. Morris Fitz. No room for any more there.
No.
I think I'd be surprised if anyone was to select a team over this past 20 years that this man would not have. Because he had, in terms of skill, he was poetry in motion.
Yeah.
And he made Gaelic football appear to be a very simple and straightforward game. Probably, you know, in terms of, I know down in Kerry, some people may have criticised him for his competitive instinct and maybe not having the same work rate. I think that was his language style that he appeared, but I've seen him playing for, you know, college and Sigerson, and he could win ball with the best of players. You know, he just wasn't a graceful player. And would Kerry have won the amount of All-Irelands had in recent years without him? Definitely not. So, fantastic player, one of the most graceful and skillful players ever to play the game, as Morris was.
He's a bit like yourself and myself, he's one of those players you don't know whether he's right or left footed.
Yeah, I've seen him hit free kicks with his left foot 45-50 yards out, kicking him over the bar, and you'd be wondering, you know, did you see that? Is that real? So, and he's still apparently still down kicking away, loves to get out onto the pitch. So one of the greats, Morris Fitzgerald.
Very good. Now into the full forward line where you've dominated so many matches yourself, so it's going to be a tough call.
Do you know what? It probably wasn't a tough call for these two corners because one of the players is that I've played at the start of my career, played again and with him, and another man still playing. So Mickey Linton.
Very good. Is Mickey still playing?
He's still running now. I don't know if he's still playing, but speed, nobody that ever played against Down, as far as I mean, could match this man for speed. And it's one thing winning the ball and getting it, but he had a score. 91 and 94 when Down won the Lairns, he was a key man. Mm-hmm. You get it into him, nobody could touch him. And again, what made him so difficult, apart from his speed, was that he could kick points off right and left foot. And again, as I said, had the privilege of playing with him, and fantastic gentleman on and off the pitch as well. And a cornerback's nightmare.
Oh, right.
The other corner forward is this man here. I don't, again, you know, some quarters people have been coming in and giving him some criticism. I can't believe it. In terms of consistency, okay, he's had a quiet day, but his standards when he kicks maybe 3 or 4 points and not in it. But no matter who's on him, and in the modern game, he has been double marked. You know, he's come out to centre half, and we can witness his full repertoire of skill in terms of his passing ability, his vision, kicking off right and left foot. And for the most part, despite boys leaping on him and pulling the jersey and all the rest, he remains focused and remains very calm. So one of the greatest footballers of his generation is the Gooch, without a doubt.
No doubt about it.
Leaves us one position,
Shane. One position, full forward, the number 14.
again, I suppose with some great full forwards down through the years I was coming into county football, and Brian Stafford, maybe you've seen him playing a number of occasions. But the man that I'm selecting here, Tony Boyle, is another man that right. I would have played with and against, and a great ball winner. But the man that I'm going for, very similar, I suppose, in that he's a very graceful player, is Pádraig Joyce.
Very good.
He had the privilege of playing with him and training with him, you know, with international rules, and you can see a close hand with yeah. what he's capable of. Left foot, second to none, yeah. What he could do with it. And some of his performances, again, very similar to Gooch, in that he had very few poor games, and over a 9 or 10 year period for Galway, he was their focal point in attack, and on many occasions he carried them. So he's one man that I would like to see at the edge of the square.
Very good. That's a team anyone would love to. Fine 15 it is too. Seeing as you're the first on this year, and I know you're probably going to miss a few players, probably when you're driving down the road you'll ring me and say, put your man in, but I'm going to give you 3 subs. So work away.
Yeah, definitely. I know you put me in the spot, and there'll be a number of men that have missed out, but forwards wins matches, so I'll get a few forwards in here anyway. I haven't mentioned, you know, Paddy Bradley, mm-hmm. and I think Paddy would definitely tell you he's better than Keelan in the Gooch, but he's a fantastic footballer, and yeah. many games that he's won basically on his own. So, fantastic player to watch.
You're lucky enough there, because I think Paddy's actually doing it next week.
That's why you have him in there. Definitely, the other, you know, when you talk about forwards and Ulster, and we played Armagh mm-hmm. on many an occasion as well, you had Oisín McConville, you had Stephen McDonald, absolutely superb. But the other forward that I didn't mention up there, and definitely worthy of his place, is Paul Galvin.
Yeah.
Again, a real warrior, yeah. and as well as being stuck in the middle of things and given plenty of aggro and all the rest, he could kick the ball over the bar. The final man, I don't have any Calvin men on, and another man that I would have admired when he was playing, fantastic forward again, and it's not Martin Dunn, who's never played. Martin would be thinking he should be on this, I know, but it's Dermot McCabe.
Very good.
He has soldiered very well mm-hmm. for years with Calvin. Fantastic left foot, great pair of hands on him, and a great servant to Calvin football, so Dermot McCabe.
No problem. Wouldn't be a best 15 without that name in it somewhere, Pete.
Gotta be here there
somewhere. Come here. Thanks very much, Pete. I appreciate your time, and I know that you'll be ringing me later on saying, I forgot about this, but we can only pick so many. Thanks very much, Pete.
Thank you.
Thanks,
yeah.
No problem.
Can you stay up for the weekend and blame God for looking too old? Can you find all that you stand for has been replaced with mountains of gold? You can untrain yourself to notice, to feel pain and swallow fear. But can you stay up for the weekend till next year? God, I can't do this anymore, though I'll be late.